Microlecture 22, the birth of American nations. Most American nations gained their independence between 1776 and 1825. After independence was secure, the new nations began a state-building process that lasts several decades. In places like the United States, Mexico, Argentina, and Cuba, some tensions culminate in civil wars and violence. To organize the new nations, American elites reach for ideologies that circulate in the Atlantic during the 18th and 19th centuries. It was a way to establish political and economic frameworks suitable for the establishment of modern states. The dominant ideology of the era was liberalism, although conservatism was also important and had political, social, economic, and cultural influence. Liberals aspired to form representative republics with a strong central government organized by constitutions that define and protect individual rights and define and limit the state's power. All the nations that adopt liberal constitutions also wanted to secure the right to own and buy and sell private property freely. Perhaps the most well-known example of this type of constitutions is the US Constitution. In its earlier form, it defined individual rights, but those rights were subordinate to property rights. For example, enslaved people were considered property rather than individuals with constitutional rights. The US Constitution also said that only property owners could vote, only men could own property, and women, African American and Native Americans were totally excluded from the political world. Thus, liberalism mainly served and protect oligarchs, the small number of individuals and families who had monopolized political power and economic resources since the colonial era. Liberalism preserved slavery, create tools that allow the wealthy and powerful to continue to concentrate land ownership in the countryside, gave industrialists a free hand over their workers, and concentrate political power in the hands of those who held the economic power. Liberalism, however, did not have a unique expression in the Americas. In many countries, the preferred system was political centralism, while in others, federalism was the route. The political tensions associated with that discussion led to many conflicts, including the Civil War in the US. In Spanish America, the implementation of liberalism was different than in the US. In that region, the lack of a shared political culture among powerful and influential groups made things more complicated. Large landowners had a lot of political power at the local level, and they refused to listen to the orders of the people in the capitals. These landowners were called caudillos, strong men with magnetic personalities who more often than not had armed supporters and a lot of money and influence. The rule of a caudillo often provided temporary stability amid the struggles between politicians, but caudillos cultivate their prestige at the expense of building stable political institutions. Despite the difficulties during the 19th century, the liberal elites in Latin America succeed in introducing the notions of constitutionalism and modern representative government in the context of traditional political systems. Elect presidents with legally defined powers replace the rule of absolute monarchs, and the idea of citizenship emerged for the first time as the basic principle of legitimate government. However, most liberal regimes in the region were unable to achieve the gradual incorporation of opposition parties and the expansion of political representation that characterized successful constitutional democracies. The divorce between liberalism and democracy in Latin America was the unintended outcome of the formal and informal institutions created by the liberal elites in the process of consolidating national unity and lowering the levels of conflict in the competition for power. The achievement of political order in a context of territorial fragmentation and factional conflict was difficult. It led to creating a centralized form of government and a system of electoral control by the ruling elites that prevented the evolution of the liberal regime into a stable constitutional democracy. Latin American liberals were deeply affected by the task of creating persuasive state authority and usually placed the values of order and stability above the idea of political liberty. They create a conservative brand of nation-building liberalism whose main concern was the creation rather than the limitation of political power. However, Latin American liberals were opposed to despotic and arbitrary rule and saw an effective protection of civil rights. They wanted a strong legal authority for exceptional times, trusting that the progress of civilization will reduce the need to restrict the sphere of political liberty. This is all I have for you today. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.